the ignition chamber. Real rough up here, fluctuating a half degree each side. 10 seconds. Altitude rising. Lot more right. Neil, you're bouncing off the atmosphere. Altitude still rising, Neil.
The Sagina launch.
flight dynamics for unmanned Athena. Target vehicle looking good. Stand by for Gemini launch. Daima, read your loud and clear. We have S man truck. We have just locked up on TM.
Switching to HF. One, two, three, four, five.
Copy.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
2 minutes.
Check out.
Stage 2. Revolves coming open. 5 seconds.
Engines to start.
Ground power removal.
T-minus 20 seconds. Mark.
Clock is running. Got a roll program in.
Roger, roll. Good liftoff.
Pitch program.
Roger, pitch program.
Stage 2 tanks look good. That's about 3.5 G's. Roger. Fuel cells are solid.
Mark, P over PR is 0.08.
Okay. Mode 3. We had Seco.
Through the night, what a thrill touching and I'll melt into you. What a fear in my heart, but you're so supreme. A tree frog, it's ordeal, the trial to survive for the day.
Climb the highest mountain? Why 35 years ago fly the Atlantic? Why does Rice play Texas? We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things, not because they are easy, but because they are hard. Because that goal will serve to organize and measure the best of our energies and skills, because that challenge is one that we're willing to accept, one we are unwilling to postpone, and one we intend to win, and the others too.
Okay, we're all set. Transmitting maneuver load. It's a height adjust. Got DCS. Roger. And are you ready to copy the update? Over. Okay. Go with the update. Hawaii.
Hey, Mom. Trying to get
Roger.
You anything?
GEP B13437. Delta B 2.9. Burn time 0+05. Roger, Hawaii. Got it. This is Paul Haynes at Gemini Control Houston. Our display chart shows Gemini 8 in orbit. The crew will now attempt to find the unmanned Agena spacecraft and dock with it.
Burn end.
Good burn. Should we have a vision on the agenda by now?
Houston, I think we overdid it a little.
8, standby for correction.
So we're getting a difference. Fido flight, how are we doing?
Okay, we got a solid track on both vehicles, calculating for the bomb.
Fido, you know, do you have what you need from us? Fido, did you copy that?
Roger, flight, I copy.
You guys getting this?
We just have some ratty data with the Gemini computer.
Need the correction, gentlemen, let's go.
Sending it up now.
This is Houston Capcom. We're going to need you to do another burn here very shortly, so stand by to copy. GETB030341. Delta V is 2 seconds posigrade. 8, do you copy?
I'm getting a horrendous 20 to 25 feet per second down, Neil.
I can't see any possible reason for that.
Where are we on the plot?
We're above it.
Right, but what does it look
like? I can't. I'm sorry. I have to look at this.
Okay.
No, I got too much to do. Okay, we're gonna do with a closed loop. 25 forward, 8 left, 3 up. And I'm going to rate command.
Copy, standing by.
3, 2, 1, burn.
Could be a planet.
Could be.
This is Houston. We have your ground TPI backup when you're ready to come.
Standby. We have a visual on the Agena.
At least something we think looks like the Agena.
Understand. Possible visual on the Agena.
We're getting a little out of plane now.
Yeah.
We got to get 3 aft and 2.5.
Going to start breaking. Give me a digital range and rate. I better back off a bit.
6,000 feet, 31 feet per second.
Put in a little to the left.
1,680 feet.
That's unbelievable.
Would you look at that? You tell him.
Houston, we're station keeping on the agenda
about 150.
Okay, stay focused, gentlemen. We're only halfway there. Thanks for the extra hands. Stay focused, gentlemen.
Man, flies easy.
Does it really?
The station keeping is just, it's like nothing.
RKV, this is 8. We're sitting at about 2 feet out.
Roger, stand by for
Roger.
Okay, Gemini 8, we have TM solid. You're looking good on the ground. Go ahead and dock.
Okay, We're going to cycle our rigid stop switch now. Wow. Flight, we are docked.
Someone call Cronkite. Have them tell the Soviets that they can go screw.
Get them on the phone, man.
And Pete, hey, call those idiots in Congress while you're at it.
Yeah, I'll start with Rhode Island.
Oh, damn!
Jiminy 8, this is Houston Capcom. Please stand by to copy.
I got my room like this. Look at all these papers.
I know.
I spent days trying to work on that, and now it's crumbled up. Look at my drawer.
I know.
I had all my crayons in that, and now look at all the crayons.
But Ricky, are you telling me the full story? Because I'm not sure your brother would do that.
Yes,
yet.
I am
now,
telling
don't you
look
get
at
angry
this.
With me.
Well, that's peculiar. I'm hoping that's just excess hydrogen.
I think we're gonna save mine for later. Neil, we're in a bank. We're not doing it. It's not us.
Shut off the Agena's control system.
Code 400. Agena control system shut down.
Cycle the Agena.
Turn it on. Turn it off. Cycle the Acme and the propellant motor valves.
Switching ADL to pitch, RL to pitch.
Low meter, 200 and rising.
Separate from the Agena.
Setting Agena to allow remote command. Switching on the DAC. Make sure you give it an extra thrust so we don't smash
on my mark. Undock. 2, 1.
Ah. OMS propellant 13%. It's not the Agena. It's us.
Gemini 8, coming back into range in 3, 2, 1. This is CSQ, checking our comlink. How do you read? Gemini 8, how do you read?
We have a serious problem.
We're tumbling end over end up here. We're disengaged from the Agena.
Okay, we got your spacecraft. Free indication here. What seems to be the problem?
We're rolling up and we can't turn anything off. We're continuously increasing in the left
roll.
CSQ flight.
Go ahead, flight.
Did he say he cannot turn the Agena off?
No. He says he's separated from the Agena and that he's in a roll and can't stop it.
Flight, their roll meter is 270 and rising. At that rate, they'll be passing out in about 40 seconds.
Ball? Got it.
always have...
Close the RCS breakers. Dave!
Did you say you were closing RCS breakers? Are you initiating RCS? Jiminy, again, did you say you were closing RCS breakers? You will not be able to control your attitude.
Regaining control of the spacecraft, slowly in RCS direct. We're trying to kill our roll right here. It's all roll right. Move us back to one ring.
Copy.
I want emergency landing options. Wait until you find out how much fuel they have left.
Bob, what do you think?
I think it's better than now.
Deke, Jan's outside.
Jan, the ship is stable. They're gonna be alright.
He's okay, Jan.
I need you to go home.
Fine. Turn the box back on.
I'll see what I can do.
Now. Turn the box back on.
Well, there's security protocols in space.
Well, I don't give a damn. I've got a dozen cameras in my front lawn, Deke. Do you want me telling them what's going on?
Jen, you have to trust us. We've got this under control.
No, you don't. All these protocols and procedures to make it seem like you have it under control. But you're a bunch of boys making models out of balsa wood. You don't have anything under control.
Naha Rescue 1 will be on station at splashdown with a flotation collar.
Did you get the call signs?
Yeah. It's Naha Rescue 1. Naha Search 1.
Well, I like to argue with them about the going home, but I'm not sure how we can yet.
Yeah.
I just keep thinking, is there anything else that we forgot?
We did everything as far as I know.
Gemini 8 saw two complex vehicles, launched on the same day on time. We saw Flores, rendezvous, and docking, all of which is tended to be overshadowed by the malfunction, but I think we should focus on the progress resulting from the mission.
The board would like to focus on the malfunction. Neil, walk us through the decision to separate from the Agena.
First, with the respect...
Did you think to use the Agena to stabilize the combined craft?
This was, not successful. As I said, we initially assumed that the anomaly was with the Agena control system, because there was no way to know that Thresher was causing the...
No. So, we're using our thumb now, honey.
Our wild ride in space.
Almost. Okay, I'm gonna cook the dinner. You try practicing that line. You practice that one.
Well, that's not my concern. I'm not interested in how other magazines are framing the story.
Okay, keep going.
Still working.
Yeah.
I was gonna go grab a beer at Dave's.
Yeah, fine.
You know, I will say one thing. It's all I can think about. It's getting back up there.
Just caught a rough break. Well, you boys did everything right. Everything. You know, I was talking about it with Gus, and we both agreed.
I did hear a little rumor that you and Gus have been hanging out.
You did?
Mm-hmm. Hey, is it true?
Is what true?
Deke pulled me aside and told me that him and Gus want me on the crew.
For the first Apollo?
Yeah. Oh my god, that's huge.
Congratulations.
Thanks, man.
Wow. That Saturn's a monster. You're in for one heck of a ride. It is.
Oh, hey, you know Decky wants Gus to be the first on the moon, so... Hey, that puts you in the LEM with him for the landing.
Oh, no, let's not get carried away.
Ed, alright, get out of my house. I gotta go to bed. I'm not kidding. Get out of my house.
I gotta tell you, Eddie's started asking questions about the new command module.
Is that right?
Yeah. He wants to know if it's gonna fly any different to Gemini. Little buttons are gonna be in the same place.
Oh boy. You got yourself a little engineer there.
Yeah. I tell you though, I love that he's interested. Came in the other morning he did. Comes running up and he says, "Daddy, if you go to the moon, are you going to be lonely out there? So far away from the Earth, all of us back here at home. This whole thing is expanding his horizons."
Walker's got a new swing set.
Yeah. Yeah, I noticed that.
We had a swing like that back up at Juniper Hills. Karen really loved it.
That's your daughter?
Guess I ought to be getting home.